What's up, guys? Leslie Robbins here for Young Hollywood outside the Beverly Hills restaurant Maude, owned by celebrity chef Curtis Stone. And I have got an exclusive look from the man himself. So, Maude, tell me how this started. It's your first restaurant.
My first restaurant here in the States. I always wanted to open a tiny little room. 25 seats was sort of the most I wanted, because the smaller the restaurant, of course, the more detail you can put into the food as a chef.
Now, how did you come up with the idea, to name it Maude? Let's start there.
That's my granny's name, my late granny. And she had this beautiful home that I always felt so special in. When I look back at it, it was all the vintage plates and the little sort of antique bits of silverware and stuff. I decided to sort of honor my granny. I went and bought a bunch of these beautiful old plates from flea markets all over the country.
Yes. Let's talk about your food. This place is really unique when it comes to your menu.
Yeah, so what we do is we take one ingredient per month, we honor that ingredient, and then we put it into a degustation style tasting menu, so about 12 courses, so that one ingredient's featured in every single course.
I want to be here when you test all that out. So how does your brain work? How does it operate and say, okay, I'm going to do this for pears, I'm going to do this for tomatoes?
We start off by saying, what's all the applications for that ingredient? Can we dehydrate it? Can we powder it? Can we turn it into a vinegar? Can we juice it? Can we cook it? Can we roast it? Can we fry it? And we write all of that out, and then we say, okay, how would it work in a structured menu? We want some seafood, we want some meat, maybe something wild. And then we sort of just craft that into something that looks cohesive.
Well, I'm looking forward to getting in the kitchen because I want to eat and try and play.
Let's do it. Okay. Come on, after you. First things first, you need to look the part, and I don't want you messing up your beautiful outfit. Just slip that over and tie it at the back. Very good. Look at this.
Wait, I can't even do this right. Cooking's gonna be fun. Don't put me near a stove.
So what I thought we'd do is something dead simple. Pear, beet, and goat's cheese salad.
Pear being the ingredient of the month.
Right. I've got a variety of different beets, truthfully, because otherwise you'll get really red fingers because beets are, you know, so colorful.
Okay.
So just go ahead and pick up a little piece of everything.
So this is art.
Just however it comes out.
Oh, I broke it.
Don't worry, drop it and get another one.
Fired already.
Yep. Come on, Leslie, you're too slow. Let's move. I've made a pear gel. It gives it a different sort of a texture. And then a pear curd.
Can I do like a smiley face?
Go for it. So the goat's cheese, I've whipped it and put it into an ISI canister. So you'll see it comes out sort of just like that.
Wait, now I have to test it out. I can't just
of course you can.
Let it sit there and look pretty. You almost want to get a little bite of everything.
Right, so I hope it looks delicate, but I hope it eats deliciously. Mm. You know, that's the goal. I like that face.
Can I just say about this? The goat cheese kind of binds all of the flavors together into one cohesive bite of amazingness.
Thank you.
And this is one course of 12.
Correct.
Let's go make some more food.
Yes.
Yes.
Here at Maude, we like to be a little bit more adventurous. Next, you're going to try a pig's head terrine. So what I've done...
Whoa! Did you just say pig's head?
Yeah. You know what? The jowls, the cheeks of the pork are so tender and so delicious.
Pig's head?
Yeah.
Wait, well, are you sure I'm going to like this?
Oh, you're going to love it. Okay, so I'm going to take these and I'm going to crisp them in a hot pan. So see how that's... You'll recognize the smell,
uh-huh.
Right? Like beautiful crispy pork skin or even a little bacon-ish sort of smell.
Mm-hmm.
In the meantime, I have a parsnip puree that I made with grapefruit juice, which gives it a little brightness. that kind of thing.
It had a little thing.
A little parsnip toffee. I just take a little on the back of the spoon and just wipe it down like that.
That's the fancy chef move.
Oh, look at that. The pear is here. So what we've done is taken raw parsnip and raw nashi pear, a little bit of maple syrup and just a tiny bit of lime juice. Go ahead and place that on your plate. A little micro watercress. This is actually gives just a tiny bit of bitterness. That's it. We're done. If you wanted to take it that next step further, you could take a little crispy pig's ear and sort of just serve that as a little cracker. You could even fry the brain.
That's the brain?
That's the brain, yeah. I think this is a fabulous dish. If she falls over, it's her problem. It's not the food's. Who knew porky bits could taste so good?
Curtis, this is really good.
I really think that we should use every single piece of that animal.
I'm sorry, it's stuck. Just, it's so, we're going in for a second.
Back seconds.
Only because I'm here, There's some alcohol involved. I'm gonna try some brain.
Let's dive in. The brain's really lightly poached. You're gonna love it. Go for it.
Sip first.
You're gonna love it.
It's lovely. I love it so good. You've converted me.
All food can be delicious. It doesn't have to be.
It's amazing. I've just eaten two amazing courses, which is usually 2 out of 12.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna pour you a little dessert wine because we always have to finish with something sweet.
Let me ask you something.
Yeah.
Best part of being a chef?
I think it's the expression on people's face when they actually eat your food, whether it's your wife or, you know, a complete stranger. It's always a beautiful feeling.
Cheers to that.
Cheers.
Thank you.